Hey everybody, welcome back to Northernlion Plays Dark Souls 2 Clerical Terror. Did I talk to Lucatiel all the way? Yeah, it seems pretty good. Just give it a second here. And there we go. So her dialogue is completely exhausted now, which is fine. Wave at me. I am tempted to summon you, because that actually says, let's do this, okay? You know, I've never summoned anybody over the course of this playthrough. I don't need to summon somebody to get through Harvest Valley, but I'm going to invite this dude in here, and I'm not going to wave at him. Or her, could be a her. As soon as they pop up, they're going to wave, and I'm going to war cry. Get ready, all right? Here it comes. Ha ha! Suck on that, motherfucker! Oh, you're gonna praise the sun too. Okay, well, you know, I can do like a pump it up! Pump it up, yeah! Hello? Alright, you know what? You've earned it. There's your wave. Oh, that's righty ho. Maybe I don't even have. Oh, there's the wave. Okay. Here you go. I waved at him. Let's see what Charles de Gaulle wants to get up to now. Okay, good. Thank you, my friend. Let's go. Now I have to deal with this guy either babysitting or being babysat by me. Why don't you jump at me, motherfucker? See what happens. That is what happens right there. So this should be much easier than it normally is with only one person. But this part of the game is not necessarily super difficult to begin with. Basically, we're just getting to the bonfire that will allow us to... thank you for... Did you not raise that? I guess there's no point. Yeah, we're just getting to the bonfire that'll be before Mytha. It'll allow us to, if we so choose, burn the windmill and thus make the fight a lot easier. That was a pretty sweet shield break from him there. I almost never use that attack, but this guy's doing work here. I have to reiterate, because sometimes people on the internet are very silly, I have to reiterate that I'm not summoning this guy to carry me through the level. Rather, I just summoned him because his name was funny. There's usually another mannequin up there. He's having some trouble getting down. He's gonna actually take the ladder! Normally, he jumps, and that makes him way scarier. But I guess in this case, he decided, you know what, my knees are shot, so I'll just walk down there like a good boy should. And again, this is the bonfire, so we've already basically made it after like 20 seconds here. So, with you being dead, I don't know, can I get through the fog wall with this man here? I think I can. Because we haven't actually done anything yet, I mean, I'll light the bonfire. Wave at me. I don't want you to disappear. You're going to help me fight Mytha, okay? Yeah, burn the... That's my job, you scumbag! Okay, well... I'm going to pop this life gem. We'll save our Estus for the boss fight. We're also going to try to summon Jester Thomas for the Mytha fight. You know, this guy has been the best summon. Oh, he can't do it. Oh, well, the truth comes out, doesn't it? All right, smart guy. I'm glad we didn't leave without that. That could have been terrible. Because that would mean that we'd have to fight Mytha with the poison still on the room. So we'll do that. And this thing will go up in smoke like a Cheech and Chong film. And we'll pick this up. Black fire bombs may end up being useful at some point. But now it's a very easy run to the Mytha fight here. Come on, wave at me. You're better than that, man. I need you to hurry up, actually. This is kind of like a... I'm trying to set the, Vancouver, BC speedrun record in Dark Souls 2. So here's how we do it, my friend. Are you ready? He's coming. Now, he'll be coming round the mountain when he comes. Summon Jester Thomas, he will touch your bums. Ooh, careful, and now we come up, and you know what? Wave at me. This one's up to you, buddy. See if you can sneak through the... Oh, no. Oh, I'm mad because I'm bad. Wave at me! He'll be riding six white horses when he comes. That was my own fault. It is my own fault. Usually that does work out, though. I'm not going to say that it was necessarily, wave at me's fault that it didn't work out. The good news is that, actually getting to this bonfire, or sorry, this boss fight, is going to take about a second and a half. But yeah, the aggro patterns, I don't know, the aggro crag was a little bit different there, if you ask me. But that's okay. If we're going to have a setback, that is a relatively minor setback. And it's just unfortunate that I wasn't able to take that glorious World War I era French military officer into the boss fight with me. Would have liked to have done that. We're going to Estus quickly. Oh, I'm going to probably die again. I'm gonna try something sneaky. And the Estus will keep me alive. Jester Thomas? Did Jester Thomas get summoned? I do not see a Jester Thomas. So unfortunately, because I'm an idiot, I may end up actually fighting this boss by myself. Which is not that bad, but Jester Thomas is a total badass. Not every other time, but... Oh, I forgot that this attack exists. I've beaten Mytha multiple times by myself, even once on my first playthrough of the game with the poison still active, because I didn't know that you could actually turn it off, which was the dumbest idea of all time for my own personal sake. Just don't get hit by the magic attack. That's the scary part. And if you can just get a couple of two-hit combos in there, I'll be fine. So that's going to explode. But that's not really that big of a threat. And then you do the old snake slither over there. That's cool. All right. So we're going to stay up with our health here. You're going to do that again. That's not so bad. Our endurance is high enough. I really thought I summoned Jester Thomas there. But I guess sometimes if you don't stand at the summon sign for like a split second longer, you run into problems. Again, this is like no issue here. All right. We're going to do this again. I mean, two can play this game, Mytha. All right. Turns out she outsmarted me a little bit. That's okay. Gonna Estus up back here. She wants to throw magic attacks at me. That's okay. I can roll out of the way. I hesitate to roll against Mytha right now, even though I just did right there. That's why, as I got burned. But I hesitate to do it just because I don't know her attacks so well. So I'm kind of waiting for an attack that I can just easily sneak out of, like so, and then throw a lightning spear or, you know, hit her where it hurts. Like that. That one's pretty good. So it's not going super well so far, I'll admit. Mytha's a super easy boss fight. I'm just so used to having Jester Thomas that I maybe, you know, I've done myself a disservice. All right, that actually is quite painful. Got to be very conservative for the remainder of this fight. Because, there we go, that's the good one right there. Because, she could probably like one or two shot me. What you got going on here, Mytha? I don't want to attack until you attack. Alright, that should be the end of this fight. Alright, could have been better, but, you know, certainly after inauspicious beginnings, I think we came out of that one totally fine. I died way more than I wanted to. Once? No, I don't. If you count Huntsman's Copes, I died once there, too. So, you know, dying twice on the way to the Iron Keep is not necessarily fantastic. So be it, though. We've now made it to the Iron Keep, and we're not going to go through with this area just yet, because I find it annoying, and we'll tackle, like, all of the great souls in one video, with maybe the exception of the last sinner, which we might lump into another video. So we still have... We're going to go Grave of Saints, Royal Rat Vanguard. After we beat the Royal Rat Vanguard, we'll go down to the Gutter. Another area I'm not super fond of, but now that I've got the path for that area down, it's pretty quick. Not speedrun world record worthy, but that's okay. And then we've got to go Shaded Forest, fight the Scorpion, and Brightstone Cove, fight Prowling Magus, and that's fine. So where do we go now? We go back to Majula. And we want to buy that Cat Ring. And we can probably get to the Rotten before the end of this episode, but it'll be a little bit of a rush, as you might expect. And 3 Estus is fine, I know. The comments for these episodes are weird. I should preface this by saying, like, I sincerely appreciate the support, but when people are like, oh, you know, you missed blah 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 in area blah blah blah. Sure, you're not wrong, but also this is definitely not like a 100% playthrough of Dark Souls 2. Even my first playthrough was not a 100% playthrough of Dark Souls 2. That being said, it was way more comprehensive than this one's gonna be. And especially at this point when people are like, why do you run past enemies? I had somebody... And I apologize if this was you, and maybe you were just having a bad day or something like that. I was having a bad day when I read the comment, too, so, you know, everybody hurts sometimes. Oh, that was, that's gonna be my death. Probably should have taken an extra second there, but I have 6,900 souls. That's pretty the magic number, isn't it? Somebody was like, wow, you just run past all the enemies? If you don't like the game, why did you buy it twice? I really like the game, and, you know, that's... You should go into, like, a speedrunner stream sometime, you know, go into, like... Cosmos playing something, or Siglemix doing Mario 64, and be like, why do you even play Mario 64? You're missing so much of the content. I'm not saying I'm a world record class speedrunner at all. Not even close. But I enjoy playing the game as quickly as possible. It's a little, it's, you know, more of my style Oh my god, I almost effed it up again. It's more of my style than, you know, being super comprehensive. If you want a more comprehensive Let's Play, go watch Epic Name Bro, man. I'm not being facetious when I suggest that, like, people go watch him. I may use, the Rouge Water here. I'm never gonna use it again, in all likelihood, so... we'll use that and just heal up a little bit. I should be fine. It's gonna hurt a little bit, though. But yeah, go watch Epic Name Bro, or, you know, if you want to stay closer to home, go watch Nick Rockley Smile, youtube.com/RockleySmile, has a very slow-moving, comprehensive Let's Play of Dark Souls 2. I don't mean it negatively. I actually mean it very positively. Go check him out. That's more your style. If you don't like watching me speed through the game, stop watching me speed through the game. That seems logical to me. But for everybody else, thank you very much for the support. Sincerely, it does mean the world to me. I'm glad that you guys like watching me play Dark Souls 2, because I like... that was really dumb of me. Didn't even need to aggro that guy. I like playing Dark Souls 2, so I think it is a pretty good match. Now, I don't think I need to fight these guys. This is a new thing for me. Usually, I do fight the rats that show up in there, but I've never actually tried just basically sprinting through the area as fast as I can, because usually... I get invaded by an NPC called Roy the Explorer here. I think you would too. But lately he hasn't been showing up, so maybe it's only if you're human, or maybe they took him out for some reason, but here's a boss fight for us. 6960. That's still pretty good in terms of like proximity to 69. Which is also the name of my post-rock band. So we're gonna put Poison Moss in our quick bar here. This is a little bit of an annoying fight with the way that I handle things. If you have more Estus or more life gems, it's not so bad. But I don't, because I used them all on an earlier fight. That's actually petrification. Maybe poison moss won't help us out at all here. But theoretically, one Drangleic sword should be enough to kill them. It's not. If you've never seen this boss fight before, and I understand there will be some people that are now that the game's available on PC watching the bosses for the first time, so I'll explain it. Basically, Royal Rat Vanguard, you kill some of these rats, and then the Rat King shows up. Then you kill the Rat King and all the rats disappear. So I'm trying to save my lightning spears for a little bit later, when I should just be able to run. And by running, oh, that's bad. By running, kill more of these guys without putting myself really in harm's way. It is a little bit of a clusterfuck, you know. One of the complaints that a lot of people, ooh, that was scary. One of the complaints a lot of people have about Dark Souls 2 is like, why are there so many like multi-target boss fights? I don't disagree. They are the most difficult boss fights in the game, though, so there's been some people that complained that, you know, Dark Souls 2 is too easy. So, you know, pick one or the other. I will accept one or the other criticism. Now, hopefully, this Rat King shows up pretty soon, because I'm taking some damage. A couple of rat bosses in Dark Souls 2, I dislike both of them, but truth be told, Royal Rat Vanguard is actually pretty easy, as long as you're not bad, which I seem to be. So I just, there was a saving icon in the top right corner for like a split second there. I wonder if that means the king's about to come. Come on. The problem as well, once we actually get the king to appear, he's very difficult to hit with a lightning spear. Not very difficult, but he's annoying to hit with lightning spears because he is surrounded by enemies and statues and stuff like that. So the king should appear somewhere. He has a funny haircut. Not you. I'm looking. I see you. You're on the other side of the world. Okay. So, what do? We kind of aggro these guys over here. Oh, big mistake. May end up dying here. Oh my god, no. Look at that bull effing S. Pop that poison moss, boy. You can still live here. I believe. No, I'm dead. Okay, that was dumb of me. What should I do? Probably pop like a divine blessing on my quick bar. Starting to run up against more deaths than I expected. That's okay, though. Again, this playthrough is, how should I put it? I don't want to say lazy, because that sends the wrong message. It's not a lazy playthrough. This is just, you know, this is your window into my world, because this is the way that I play the game when I play it myself as well. So, really, it would be unnatural if I played differently, because that is not the style that I like to use. So I'm thinking that maybe we'll F with our style a little bit here. Maybe instead of saving the lightning spears, we'll use as many lightning spears as we can, kill the rats, and that way we'll still have 3 Estus left for when the king shows up, or at least 2 Estus left for when the king shows up, and then we can just basically two-hand our weapon, tank the shit out of it, and destroy him. I do die against this fight more than I would like to admit. For some reason, you know, lately, it seems like I have been having more trouble on the quote-unquote easy boss fights in Dark Souls 2 than the difficult ones. Oop. Yeah, I was afraid of that. I hit those statues all the time, which is probably the reason they're here from a gameplay standpoint, but let's see if I can get that guy and a couple of his little rat friends. There we go. More attacks in here. That worked really well. Okay, that is a much better way to handle this fight. Yes, we don't have lightning spears for when the king shows up. Oh, actually, we still have two. Let's just do a little crowd control here. That one looks pretty solid. And... oh, man, that was actually pretty bad. Let's throw some hexing urns at him. I just picked them up. Might as well use them. All right, we actually did do some damage to the king with that one. I never use these items except for situations like this. I might as well enjoy it. It's amazing how much easier this fight is when you actually take a second to plan. Now, you're gonna come at me? That's up to you. I would advise against it, but that's your choice. Don't die again. Quickly, Estus. Not Estus. That would be quite vulgar for my personal taste. Where are you, Rat King? There you are. Try... oh! I don't have any lightning spears left. I should have known that from earlier. So these rats never disappear. That's what I think I have to learn. So what I try to do here is maybe separate the rats from the Rat King. And hit the Rat King with another Hexing Urn. Might as well. That didn't actually hit the Rat King. Did I just punch him with the chime? Okay, I'm throwing super hard here. This is by far the easiest of the rat fights that actually happen. And yes, there are more than one. Rat King, where you at, my friend? Not there. Rats are and spiders are like my fucking kryptonite in this game. Not the Three Doors Down style, although that's pretty bad too. Alright, perfect. Do some damage to you. The king is the rat who does not disappear. There we go. Oh, it feels good. Oh, he poisoned me. Divine Blessing is why, or this is the reason we put Divine Blessing on our quick bar here. He toxifies us or poisons us in like one hit. And Divine Blessing restores an awful lot of health. All of it, apparently. Come on, just get the Rat King isolated. This is like the slowest fight. Oh my god. I'm gonna take a sip of my water. I'm going to relax a little bit. This is not a Dark Souls 2 rage through. This is a Dark Souls 2 playthrough. And having fought this motherfucker so many times, I really did not expect that this would be as annoying as it actually is. That's okay, though. I'm gonna pop an effigy quickly. And if I end up, like, just not being able to beat this, I'm gonna be pretty disappointed in myself. I'm pretty sure I beat this on my first try actually playing the game, like, borderline blind. Well, I guess I was blind when I played through the first time. So, yeah, I'm disappointed with the way that this is going, but that's okay. I think this is definitely a much better strategy to, you know, lightning spear the shit out of the rats ASAP. And as a result of doing this, I should really just be more patient. That's my problem when I fight bosses that have multiple foes. I'm just too impatient. Five lightning spears and a couple of attacks was enough to get the king to come out last time, so I'm hoping... that continues to be the case here. Let's see if that's correct. And we'll just go. Okay, so that's one Estus. Just be cool with this guy. Seriously? Alright, Witching Urn. That does like... maybe it did a lot of damage, but we didn't see it all. Because of the fact that he was so close to death anyway. Is that the king? If that was the king, we would have been in a much better position. There we go. That should do it. We killed like 15. We probably killed 6. But to me, it feels like 15. Actually, that should be 7 because we used our lightning spears as well. Maybe you have to kill 10? I don't know. One of these days, I'll figure that out. There we go. Maybe it's just a matter of time, actually. Before we get the shine. Run. There's the king. Okay. Now you... are kind of a dick. There we go. That's the moment of tooth right there. And we'll do the same thing again. And then we'll run away like a scared little baby, which I am, if I'm being honest with you, a little frightened. That's okay, though. Everybody gets scared sometimes. And we did that one in the middle there. Get some lightning spears going. Oh! That guy still did damage to me, but I did get some lightning spears going. Just need to separate the vanguard, or the king, from everybody else. And if I can do that, then life's good. I see him! I can actually have a good shot with my lightning spear. We'll probably get caught on some... We did it. Okay. That was way more difficult than it actually needed to be. And I apologize for it. Believe you me, I apologize for it. That was really annoying. Normally I don't die at all in that boss fight. To die twice was very tedious. And like I said, hopefully we'll get to the Rotten, but that definitely puts a damper on things. I used to think that this boss was super easy, and then the gutter was super hard. Now I don't know what to think. Now, we'll talk to you later, Ratman, once we start talking about invasions. Talking about PvP invasions. PvP invasions. Anyway. Who wrote that song? Did the Who wrote that song? Now. Come down and down and down. And there actually is pretty scary part. Not here. I don't think I even normally get this item. Bleedstone. Okay. Oh, I think I do. But I always forget because this is bridge number 2. I don't worry about the Titanite lizards too much. And that should be obvious, I suppose. We'll come down here and open this bad boy up. I forget, we get like a pale stone? Ash knuckle ring. So that's petrification resistance. Might as well put it on because we've got the ability to. And we could realistically get petrified down here. There's some seriously like annoying bullshit that happens. That ghost scared the crap out of me. There's just non-stop exploding dick bags. And they come out from all freaking sides. I didn't think they were petrifiers, but some of them are. Not these guys. Oh! That was very close to my own death. That was the last one, though. Alright, so plenty of bloodstains down here, and I've been those bloodstains a couple of times, I'll admit. Charcoal pine resin. That's actually pretty useful. Is this the exit, or is this an item? This is the exit, which is fine. I forget what the item is, but I seem to recall it not being crazy useful. We'll come down this way. And there's with the gutter, which is the next area we're going to, I get turned around now and then. Sometimes I think I'm going in the right direction, and sometimes I end up getting lost. But really, what concerns me is that sometimes I end up being right next to a bonfire when I come out, and sometimes I run, sometimes I hide, sometimes I'm scared of you, but all I really want is to hold you tight, treat you right, be with you day and night. Baby, all I need is time. Sincerely, I'm going to try to get to that bonfire right away because I know the route from there. But on the stream that we did on Thursday, I did get through the gutter without actually resting at the bonfire because I basically just went in the wrong direction. There is a right and a wrong direction. And I chose poorly. Now, I think this is the way I went before, which is probably a bad thing. So we'll just roll down here. Ah, there's the bonfire. Okay, so we're fine. Disregard that. I'm not going to summon this guy. I think my summoning has been bad luck for me so far. And we're not going to go back to Majula, even though we have 22,000 souls. Not that big of a deal the souls are now that we have our equipment sorted out anyway. So what we want to do on the gutter is make our way over to that fog wall that's in the distance there. This is one of the longer stretches to get to a bonfire in the game, I would say. Now, I forget if this floor breaks underneath us. Well, I remember that this floor breaks underneath us. I believe we can still make the jump that I wanted to make. I've only got 4 minutes of torch time here. That's actually pretty low. These guys are all dead. It is low. Typically, like, by the end of the game, I have, like, 3 hours, but you know, we can deal with 4 minutes for now, so we want to make this jump. Ooh, that was pretty close, because the hollow was, like, right freaking next to me. Alright, and there you go. So we'll light this. This is the only time I actually use torches in the entire game, so now that we have, like, 9 minutes, that's going to be more than enough for us to do whatever we want to do. And I definitely remember coming through this way when I was playing it on the stream. Lots of bloodstains. That's scary. Why are there so many bloodstains? Poison statues. Oh, yes, and this door that can't actually be opened. So I'm gonna moss up quickly, just so we can get out. Probably didn't need to, could've just run around, but better safe than sorry. There's not too many more poison-rich areas in the game. I guess there's maybe like, oh no, bad roll. So there's maybe like a giant behind there or something? That's why that seal's there? Maybe you need the seal of the king? Can't remember. 100%. Alright, so I believe we're still more or less on the right track here. 3 lightning spears per dog is okay. Some of these dudes are gonna come back to life. I thought he dropped like a soul item or something. No? Alright. Another one? Nope. So we'll take the ladder up. If you want a, like a walkthrough about how to get through the gutter, I'm not your guy. That should be pretty obvious, though. I very frequently find myself turned around in here. For whatever reason, it ends up working out for me. Maybe because I've suffered through this area so many times that by now I just sort of get it. I just sort of know where the outs are. And, you know, again, 7.5 minutes of torch left is enough. We can't use the shield, but... Oh, come on. You can't use a shield, but that's actually okay. I should really just use my standard attack. That seems to be working totally fine. Why get overly risky? So we want to be on those bridges. Or near those bridges, at least. Is there anything for me to do here but jump over there? I can take this path around and then get immediately frustrated. And then on that side, they're like, he won't do the same thing again. You watch me, motherfucker. Don't tell me what I can't do. Seriously? If those things shot at me, I would have been displeased. I can't remember if this is, like, a way to go. But here we are. Commentary suffers a little bit, I would say, on, already killed these guys. Commentary suffers a little bit on this point in the game because I'm just not, very well versed with the directions that I'm supposed to be taking. We've already been through here, obviously. I'm gonna take a quick second to Estus up. Is there another elevator up? Or not elevator, ladder. There's another ladder up. Maybe we could just jump and roll onto that bridge, which will take us a little closer to the fog wall. Looks like it's blocked, though. We can get onto that bridge. What am I doing here? That's okay. Do you want to... Oh, my... Ugh, okay. Take the poison moss quickly. We're back in this area, so I think I made a wrong turn somewhere, maybe. Let's try not to do that this time. Oh, because you know what the problem is? I fell in that hole last time. There's nothing to do but fall in the hole. I'm not pleased with myself right now. Like how your dude gets staggered when he gets hit with the poison. He's like, oh, shit. That was a really stupid idea of me. What the heck is that? Oh, it's just meat. Alright, so we did fall through that hole last time, but that's where we want to go. This is like when your dad takes you on a vacation, and nobody wants to go on the vacation but your dad. And you're like, oh, Dad, you don't even know where to go? What the fuck, man? Why'd you even take us here? And then, you know, he just says, like, I just wanted us to have fun as a family. And then you get a little older and you realize that, oh, shit, I was, like, a terrible kid. He just wanted to spend time with his loved ones and we were totally shitty about it. Now, that's the place where I fall into. So I don't want to go that way. Come back up here. I've almost whittled down my few remaining torches. We can't make that jump. Are you crazy? If you're gonna be crazy town, at least write a song about oral sex. Alright, well, at this point I'm like, shit, maybe we should try to make the jump. Everybody misses the first jump. The matrix.jpg. We're gonna try to be the one person that makes it. Yep, nicely done. We'll fall into the abyss. I'm displeased with myself. We should be able to get to at least the second bonfire in the gutter, though. This is the... this is the point where I'm like, I just did this on Thursday. Why is it so much harder for me to do it now? It shouldn't be. I've done it so many times, and recently. But the upper gutter I always get turned around in. I hope you're enjoying the playthrough regardless. The easier way to get there is to kind of take this path, but... Oh my god, I was seriously just like one bridge away. There's a dog over here. Oh my god, I was like one wrong turn away from where I should be. And yes, I know there's like 22,000 souls over there. I don't care. We'll get him back when we beat the boss. Oh, but that could have paid for 2 upgrades to your greaves. I don't care. It's okay. Don't worry about it. Let me worry about my money situation. You just worry about you. Now, that... I'm always amazed when that doesn't kill you. Apologies for being kind of dark on the screen right now. Oh my god, this is serious damage there. Oh my god, there's more. Yeah, apologies for it being dark on the screen right now. Not much I can do about that. Well, I can carry a torch. Be cool here. They chased me, yes. You know what? I do have a flame butterfly. I've never used one before. Does it actually just work? Use. Yeah, okay. Oh, okay, I see. I'm an idiot. Okay, so we set this torch alight, or this sconce alight. I was gonna say, you're telling me that didn't work? And, oh, you guys are both dead, okay. So, once these hollows come up here, how do they always know when I'm about to attack and then get me? Maybe because I'm too predictable. And we'll get that, and now we start having to cross these bridges, if I am correct. Oh, careful. We start having to cross these bridges with the exploding dicks on them. Not exploding, oh, okay. Nope, 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 yes, okay. That hollow falling from above kind of freaked me out there. What did he drop this time? Poison throwing knife, okay. And... take your time. Yeah, take the ladder, who cares, man. No rush, right? Always rush. Obviously, there is a dog here. How do you handle dogs? You walk them onto these bridges, for the most part, and make sure you don't accidentally fall off. That's a big, important part of the whole process here. And you hit him like so, and there you go. Dogs are dead. We still have a torch hollow. Among the more annoying enemies in the game. I always forget, where's the fog wall from here? I think we're not supposed to come up here. I think we just have a chest and despair up here. But the fog wall is like right there, right? So I might be mistaken in that. Maybe we are supposed to jump off that way. This is not a mimic. Common misconception. It is just 3 black fire bombs, which is kind of a waste. Oh, so this is definitely not where we're supposed to be. But I'm remembering, slowly but surely. Nope, I wanted to pick up the item. Poison, 1 poison throwing knife. Oh, remarkable. Now, cool. Come around to the other side, I guess. Don't fall. There we go, 1's dead. The other's dead. And I don't think this is the right way to go either. But it's good to know. I guess we come over this way. You have to forgive me. It hasn't been a while. That would be a very convenient excuse to use, though. One thing you can do here is put fire bombs on your quick bar and go like whoop. That'll blow those up. And that's something I learned after my last series of Dark Souls 2, where I got hit by these freaking things and I was like, there's nothing I can do to stop it. And then people were like, just use, oh, these poor fuckers here. People were like, just use a firebomb, you idiot. And they were totally right, to be honest with you. Now, there's enemies up here. There is, at the very least, 1 more exploding cocksucker. Come on, aggro, you fuck. Maybe he's over here. Where are you at, my friend? What? Okay. Apparently, I seem to have been mistaken. We don't need to do this. Remember when I kill you, as I take out the wrong weapon. But remember when I kill you, that you were the one who came in here acting all tough, and I was the one who had to put you down. Now I believe, if we just kill this guy, is this the large club in here? Is this what I didn't go through last time to get, or the great club, sorry? I think it is the great club, we'll see. Oh, it's the Wicked Eye Great Shield, actually. I just want to quickly check out what that looks like in our inventory. Like so. It looks pretty cool. Oh, Lord. Here comes the cat patrol. What's your problem, Ruka? And Tomo, too, of course. Okay. Now. Don't miss. That was a pretty big miss. That one was better. Throw some firebombs down there. Wow, those actually do more damage than I was anticipating. And that will, at the very least, unless I fall off here, be the end of the upper gutter, which is by far the worst part of the gutter. We can put our torch away for a second here. By far the worst part of the gutter. Let's break this wood with our chime, because I'm mad. And I apologize for being salty, because I'm faulty there, but at the very least, we did get through the upper gutter. As always, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, click the like button. It helps out a lot. We're making our way through the great soul bosses here. Rotten will be next, and we may actually fight him while we're here. But in any case, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.